a clothing event was yesterday. I don't know how many of you were here, but I just see a few faces I saw yesterday. We had wonderful volunteers who worked tirelessly, putting everything out, helping people select things, and then cleaning everything up. Then, of course, the chairs had to be set up, and the floor had to be swept. So we had quite a day. I was greeting people at the door, giving them a bag to put the goodies in that they picked up. So we had went through about 260 bags. So that's probably how many people were blessed in here yesterday. Some came back for a second bag when they had kids with them. We had children's toys. We had clothes for the kids. And then we had women's shoes, clothes, purses, hats. And then we had a men's section back here. Never seemed like we have enough stuff for the guys. I don't know why that is. I guess we don't get enough donations from the men, but we do. So our table cleaned out pretty quick. But we got a lot of women's clothes in here. And it was a wonderful day. And then Pastor Gabriel came at 4 o'clock, and he served some Chinese food to everybody. So it was a very full day. It was a blessed day. It was wonderful in here. We had a very, very good time. I want to thank our volunteers. They worked very hard. And especially Sister Teresa, I don't know where she is right now. She's the tall one that hollers a lot. Hey, no, that's not her. She hollers a lot. She's my drill sergeant. When there's something needs to be organized, she gets right on it. She takes care of it. And she just was all over the place yesterday, making sure everybody was taken care of. We're just so grateful to everybody who helped. And thank you very much. I hope some of you were able to come and partake and get some clothes. But the next time we announce that we're having a big event, make sure you come in for it. We really had a wonderful time. We had stuff to hand out at the door. We had blankets and, I don't know what you call it, the sparkling flavored water bottles and chips and stuff like that. But we didn't have it come in. We had it as you went out because we don't want people eating and drinking and handling the clothes and spilling stuff on them. That wouldn't be too nice. So anyway, it was a wonderful day. We went home very, very tired and exhausted. And I sure slept good last night. Man, did I sleep good last night. Didn't sleep good the night before. I think I was apprehensive about the events the next day, so I just was kind of tossing and turning all night. But yesterday, I slept great. I was very happy. Oh, man, I was out cold. And I wasn't even working the hardest. I was sitting there in a chair, handing out bags. I didn't even have to stand up all day. So the ones that were doing that, my hat's off to you, literally. This hat's off to you. And we're so grateful for everybody's help. So that event is over now, and we will have clothing for women today to pass out outside the door after service. We will have the snacks and the coffee to serve after the last amen. And hopefully the groceries will arrive during the service so that we can have those to pass out right after service. If they're not here immediately after service, they will be here hopefully sometime. He doesn't really guarantee anything. I just think he doesn't have anywhere else to take them on Sunday, so he brings them to us. So that's a blessing for us, and I'm pretty sure we'll be here. I can't promise, but I'm pretty sure. Anyway, I think that's all of the announcements we have. I can't think of anything else to announce. I'd like to open our service with a word of prayer. I hope you'll join me. Heavenly Father, precious Lord God, we thank you, Lord, for another day. We thank you, Lord, for this sanctuary, located in a perfect spot, just a perfect place for us to have our church. And Father, as you know, Lord, I didn't mention it, and I should have, that our church was founded in 1988. That's 35 years as of October. 35 years this church has been in Skid Row. And Lord, we're very proud of that fact because you made it happen. You made it happen. You keep our doors open, Father. You keep us going. And you keep blessing us, Lord. And we're so grateful that you do. This sanctuary where we can come together and praise your holy name as a family. We are all sisters and brothers here, Father. With you as our Father, we are all sisters and brothers. And this house is filled with love. We thank you, Lord, for that. Lord, we thank you for the event that we had yesterday. It was successful. We didn't have any problems. And Lord, that was also because of you. We prayed for that hedge of protection around this place yesterday. And Lord, I want to pray again for that hedge of protection around us today to give us peace in this house, that we won't have any loud outbursts or any interruptions. Lord, I ask that you place warrior angels at our doors with their swords drawn, ready to do battle with the enemy should he try to come in this building, that he dare not cross our threshold. And Father, I pray that most earnestly. We would like to have peace in the house today. Lord, I want to lift up Pastor Tony in prayer. He is doing better. He's following doctor's orders and walking. He's supposed to be walking. And even though it hurts, you gotta push through the pain. That's what I do. Just gotta keep going. Gotta keep going. The doctor told him, Lord, that if he stops walking, he won't be able to walk. So he listened. He finally listened. He get up and walk. So thank you, Lord, for that. I want to lift up Sister Teresa Carr in prayer. She's been in the hospital. Not quite sure exactly what happened. They were testing her to see if she had maybe a little mini stroke, but I didn't hear the results of the test. I hope it wasn't that. But she's a little under the weather right now. So we pray for her, Father. Also, we pray for Sister Rosalyn, who spent some time in the hospital this past week. So anybody else who had any kind of medical problems and was needing medical care this week, Father, I want to lift them up in prayer. And anybody who is a member of our church who is too ill to attend, Father, I want to raise up them right now and ask that you touch them with your healing mercies. And Father, as we pray for them, I want them to feel your arms around them, to literally feel your healing hands touching them so that they can get better and come back to church so we can welcome them back in good health. Father, I ask that you bless this service today from beginning to end. Bless our prayers, bless our songs, bless our offering, bless the message today as it comes forth from Minister Eugene. He's going to be preaching today, and I'm sure he has a powerful message. Been working on it for a while, so he always has a good one. So, Father, we thank you for all of the substitute ministers who come up here and preach in turn, so that Pastor is bringing up new leaders in the church, and that's one of the main goals he had when he took over as pastor, as you know, Father, that he wants to bring up new leadership. And that's been very successful, dear Father, because of you. We thank you, Lord, for that. Father, I'm just so grateful for everything that we have here at this church and all the wonderful people that we have here and all the love in this house. So, Lord, we thank you for that. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
How's everybody doing? Isn't it a beautiful day to give God some praise?
Yes, it is.
Seek him first, all things will be added. Amen. How many Thanksgiving season, but we should be thankful all every day. Every day. So this song just simply reminds us that the best way to keep a grateful heart is just give God praise in all things. Amen?
Amen.
I don't need another reason but that I woke up this morning. So as we praise God this morning, can you guys join us by helping us give God some praise? Because how many of you know that every praise belongs to God? Come on, you might as well go on and get your praise on. Because every praise belongs to God.
Every praise is to our God.
Come on, let's give the Lord a hand. Praise.
I worship you. I worship you. You are here working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. You are here moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you. You are here working in this place. And I worship you. I worship you.
Thank you.
never stop, you 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 never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. You make the miracle work, the promise keeper, the light in the darkness. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. We make the miracle work. You never stop working. Even in the first year, it's a word of promise keeper. Right in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
That's who you are. We make
the miracle.
Find out to me, God was the one.
just running after me. Your goodness is running after me. Your goodness is running after me.
My life
takes up the surrender of God. I give you my everything. Your goodness is running after, me. Oh,
Shape of their eyes and the color of their skin. Don't judge them that way. Judge them for who you find out they are. Get to them. Find out. If there's love in their heart toward you, there shouldn't be any hate in your heart toward them. We need to have peace. Peace in our hearts. And tolerance for others who are not just exactly like us. God made us all different. He made us all different. He did that on purpose. What a boring world it would be if we all looked exactly the same. you wouldn't know who you were talking to. Everybody looks just alike. So we're all different, and that's for a reason. And I'm grateful we are. I'd like to offer up a prayer right now for our world. And our world is in desperate need of prayer. Most of the problems in this world are created by hate and intolerance. That's what the wars are about. That's what the shootings are about. That's what the problems are about. If we just wipe hate off the face of the earth, then we wouldn't have any problems, would we? Not really. Wipe that hate out. Don't let yourself get caught up in hating anybody for any reason. Hope you'll join me in this prayer. Heavenly Father, Lord God, we come before your throne once again this morning. Father, before your throne of grace and mercy, where would we be if not for your grace? Before your throne of power and might, Father, you rule and reign. You rule and reign. You are the one we turn to. You are the one we turn to in times of need, in times of joy, in times of sorrow. You are the God that we pray to. Father, we love you, we trust you, we believe in you. And we know, Lord, that you have only our best interests at heart in our lives. We come to you with our sins and you forgive us over and over and over again. And Lord, we're so glad you do. Father, we know that you know about all the problems in this world. We know that you're aware of every single thing that's going on. And I don't think you're any happier about some of it than we are. But Lord, I know you have a plan. We don't understand what it is, but you do. And that's all we need to know. Your will, not ours, be done in heaven and earth. So, Father, we thank you for all the blessings that you give to us. And, Lord, we're sorry when we don't walk right, when we're letting you down, when we turn toward evil instead of toward good, Father. We need to be forgiven. So, Lord, I hope in this room there is no hate in our hearts toward anybody. And let us spread the word. Let us wipe out hate. Let us spread love. Let us spread it as fast as COVID spread it all over this world. And it did spread all over this world pretty fast. Let us spread love to everyone we come in contact with, Father. Teach us to love. Teach us to fill our hearts with love. And just abolish hatred altogether. We ask this, Lord, in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen, church. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand. Praise.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. It is offering time. It is time to give back to God just a percentage of what God gives to us. He wakes us up every morning. He puts food on our table when we don't have no money in our pocket. And this is a season to be thankful, amen? This is a season of thanksgiving. So what better way to show God your gratitude and your thankfulness than by supporting a church that supports this entire community, amen? So as we give, let's give with a grateful heart, amen?
Amen.
Thank you. Multiply back unto the givers a hundredfold. Father God, give back to them. Open up the windows of heaven and pour out blessings, God. Because you're a blessing, God. All you ever wanted us to do is to obey. Obey your word. Don't be afraid to give, Father God. Because by the time we get through, realize that you're a giver, we find out, God, that you've been giving to us our whole life, God. So we're honored to be able to just give back. In Jesus' name, Father, I just say a special God bless you to all the people in the house that labor in this house, God. I'm lifting up all the laborers right now. We know, Father God, that people are laboring. They're tired and they still labor because we just want to give you honor, God. We just want to give you glory. So, God, bless all the laborers that are in the house that labor all through the week, dear God, that give up their time, their energy, and their own resources just to come and serve you. And Father, I'm lifting up everybody that came in the house to give you praise this morning, God. You said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his kingdom. And you, Father, you said all things will be added unto us. So Father, I'm just speaking blessings on everybody that just took time out of their day to be here this morning to give you praise, God. And I pray, Father God, that every need is met today, that every need in this house is met. Because Father, we know all of our needs are met according to your riches and glory through Christ Jesus, we pray in Jesus' name. Let all that agree with that verse. Amen.
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 Our last song and final song, we tried it last weekend because the speakers weren't working. Amen.
Amen.
So we're going to do it again. Amen. How many know all of our help comes from God? Anything you need. I like to say it like this. If you got God, you got everything you need.
Amen.
If you ain't got God, you can have a pocket full of money and you ain't got nothing.
Amen.
When you got God, that's where all of our help comes from. Our help comes from, it comes from the Lord. Amen. Amen. This is just a reminder.
Thank you. Good to see everybody out there as I come up here tripping. Yeah, but it's working out. Things have gotten better. Y'all have seen me here for the last few steps that I've been doing, and it's getting better, ain't it?
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Anyway, until I get a little bit better, I'm kind of turning the reins over to some of my leaders that I got here. And I've been using Gary to pieces. If you notice, when he gets up to walk, he just falls apart. I love my brother Gary, though. He's always there to be used. And as I look out here in the audience, I see some brothers and sisters out here that I'm going to start training them so that I can use them. Amen. And so if you are one of those that would like to be used in leadership, you come on and see me, okay? And we'll go ahead and get that taken care of. But anyway, today we're going to have Brother Eugene once again. He's coming forward. And Brother Eugene, he's got a good, solid voice that put together a very, very wonderful message. So why don't we turn our attention over to Brother Eugene right now as he's getting me my... And we'll go ahead and let him give us the message today. Amen?
Amen. Amen, amen, amen. Praise the Lord. So God is good. It feels so good to be in the house of the Lord. It's always a privilege when God brings you here to speak his word and to do his will, period. I've been accompanied by my wife. She's here today. I'm so happy she's here today. I tried to make her stay home because she got that gout in her feet. But she said, you're going to God's house. You think I'm going to lay up in the bed? Why are you going to God's house? You got to be kidding. You crazy. You got to be kidding. She got on up, got dressed, said, I'm going. I said, okay, baby, I ain't arguing with you. You know what? Let's go. I got your back. Don't worry. That's what God put me there for. To take care of you in time of need. As you take care of me in times of need. We take care of each other. And that girl, she read the Bible more than I do. Seriously. I look over there, I say, baby, what you doing? Oh, I'm reading my verse for the day. A couple hours later, baby, what you doing? Oh, I'm reading my verse for lunch. And I look over there and say, baby, what you doing? I'm having my dinner. I have to eat the word 3 times a day. I be looking at her like, girl, you gotta be full. She said, not yet. So, God is good. I want y'all to know that everybody knows this. God is good. You know, James said that when you're going through trials, count it all joy. Because God is right there. Whatever you're going through, whatever you're going through, whatever it may be, whatever type of sickness, whatever type of illness that you're facing, call on him. He's right there. He's right there. God is. Praise him. Anyway, let's get to prayer. And before I pray, I want to say this. And I do this every time I get up here and preach. I would like for quiet time in the house. I would like for some of the ushers to get on the door to make sure nobody walk in during this time. And I just want to give this 1 minute. I want you to reach inside of yourself in a quiet moment and pour out your heart to God. Amen? Let's go to God right now for 1 minute of quiet time. Let's go to God in prayer. Father, on this day, at this time, hear us as we call out to you. Let the Holy Spirit come upon this house of worship. Let the Holy Spirit fill the hearts, the minds, and the souls of everyone that can hear. Open up the ears of them that are spiritually dead. Let that word come forth as a two-edged sword. Pierced in the soul, pierced in the spirit, pierced in the joint, and pierced in the marrow. And discerning the thoughts and the intent of our heart. Oh Lord, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, and God of Jacob, creator of heaven and earth and all things within. Hear us on this day, and that thy will be done. Bless this house. In Jesus' name we pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Let everyone who's in agreement with this prayer say, amen. Good morning again. I'm not sure if I know everyone that's here, but I am sure I know most of the people that's here. But I'm Minister Eugene, as they say. But you can call me minister, or you can call me preacher, or you can call me brother, or you can call me child of God, and you can call me a few other things I can think about, you know? But as long as God is walking with me, I don't care what you call me. See, my focus is on you. Not getting to know me, but getting to know God the Father. Because the most important issue is not that you are calling me, but that you are calling him. As you can see, there's a part of us called flesh. And flesh will fail you. Flesh will fail you. You see, don't look toward me, because if you look toward me and I let you down, the next thing you're going to say is, oh Lord, you should have been calling him from the beginning. Because man will fail you. But the Father said this. He said, I will never leave you, nor will I forsake you. So it is obvious who you should call on. Turn to whatever situation you are facing in your life. Whatever you are going through, whatever your sickness may be, whatever your physical condition may be, whatever your ailment may be, whatever problem that you're having in your life, turn to the right source. Turn to our Father. Turn to God. Because no man can do what God does. He said in the book of Hosea, he said, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject you. Yes, sir. This is what God is saying. You're perishing because of lack of knowledge. If you don't understand the will of God, if you don't study the word of God, if you can't get the will of God inside of you, if you can't get the knowledge from the Holy Spirit that he sent you, if you can't begin to walk in it, you're headed straight to hell. I'm going to say it just like it is. There's only two places that you can go. One is heaven. I don't have to tell you that one. Y'all know, all of y'all know. Because all of us in here have been going through hell at some time in our life. All of us in here have had a little feel of what it feels like to be burned by something or somebody. But we know what it feels like. And you make that little hell that you went through and multiply it times 100. And then you know what hell feels like. So there's only two places. Jesus said this. He said, but whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father, which is in heaven. When you denied Jesus, you denied God. When you denied Jesus, you denied the Holy Spirit. When you denied Jesus, you denied the only begotten of the Father. And all three of them is one. Yeah. All three of them is one. In 2 Timothy 2:15, it says this, and I think you heard me say it before. Study to show thyself approved unto God. Unto God, not unto man, not unto me, but unto God. A workman that needed not to be ashamed, but rightly dividing the word of truth. When you study the Bible, you study God's word. And when you study God's word, you're not studying it for the benefit of others. You study it for the benefit of yourself. And when you study for the benefit of yourself, God know what you're doing. God know where you're headed. God knows already that you're being obedient to his word. And once you study the word and the word not getting inside of you and it start moving around, that Holy Spirit start moving you, God say this, he said, trust in the Lord with all my heart. Lean not to my own understanding, but in all your ways, acknowledge him. And he shall direct your paths. These four scriptures alone is enough that speaks volumes of understanding to you. These four verses I have expounded on should be enough to guide us through this life journey. But Jesus knew that we would always need him during the life of this world. That's why he died for our sins yesterday, today, and forevermore. Jesus died for all our sins. Jesus act on the cross was for every sin you could ever commit. Whether you did it yesterday, whether you did it this day, and whether you're going to have life to do it tomorrow, another day, because tomorrow never comes, they say. And whenever you do it, Jesus had already died for it. All you got to do is turn from your wicked ways. Give it to him.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Give it to him. That's why I hope that everyone was listening to the message last Sunday, when Minister Gary Carr preached, that brother right there, he preached on the fact that God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit is the gospel. Do we know what the gospel is? The word of God. The word of God. And it is known fact that the gospel is Jesus Christ. It is a known fact that the gospel is God. It is a known fact that the gospel is the Holy Spirit. And it is a known fact that the word of God is according to the scriptures. In Genesis 1:1, God said, the word of God said this, it said, in the beginning, God created the heaven and earth. In the beginning, God created the heaven and earth. In John 1:1, it said this, in the beginning was the Word, And the Word was with God. And the Word was God.
Yeah.
And John 4:24 says this. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. You see, we have the understanding. We need the understanding to know how to worship God. We need the understanding to know how to praise God. We need the understanding to know how to walk with God. We need the understanding to know how to talk with God. We need understanding to know that God is always there for us. We need that understanding. And God has given it to us. In John 14:89, Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father, and it suffices us. Jesus said unto Philip, he said, have I been with you so long that you don't know me? He that hath seen me, said, hath seen the Father also. What did he say? He that hath seen me, have seen who? In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He that hath seen me hath seen the Father. Today I would like to speak to you on an area of our lives that is very significant. It is important that we understand our relationship with God. And the only way that you will understand truly your relationship with God is if God lived with you, if God lived in you, and if God lived through you. Jesus said this to Philip in verse 10. He said, I am in the Father, and the Father in me. The word that I speak, if not of myself, but the Father that sent me, he do all the work. You see, to have a relationship with God, you must know him. And the question is, what steps do you take to accomplish that? What step do you take to have a relationship with God? What step do you take to know God? What step do you take to allow God to live in you? What step do you take to fulfill the will of God in your daily life? What step do you take to be a God-like, a Christ-like person? Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, the title of today's message is Putting God First. There's only one way that you can understand God. There's only one way that you can know God. There's only one way that you can walk with God. There's only one way that you can be a servant of God. It's about putting God first. Can everyone stand as we read from the Bible? Exodus chapter 20, verse 3 through 5. Exodus 20. I got it, Gary. Verses 3 through 5. And the word of God reads like this. Please open your ears, hear God's word, and hear what he's saying to you. He said, thou shalt have no other God before me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in the heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the waters under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquities of the fathers upon the children up unto the third and fourth generation of them that hate me. You may be seated. There are three specific areas that are required for us to observe here. Reading that scripture, God's law, God's decree, and God's commandment. God's law, God's decree, and God's commandment. God's law, what is it? How many people know God's law? What God's law is? God's law is a system of rules given by God that reflects the heaven, the earth, and creation. God's decree is an official order issued by legal authority. God's commandment, a divine rule given by authority that is to observe and fulfill, given by God, given by authority. Nobody has authority to give God commandment but Him. We can speak them, but they come from God. Amen. We can speak them, but they come from God. See, God tells us what to do. Sister Geraldine said it when she was up here. Matthew 6:33. God tells us exactly how to find Him. God tells us exactly how to reach Him. God tells us exactly how to be still and let Him work in your life. See, God don't hide nothing. Everything is in His Word. Anytime you need God, you know how to go to Him. Why? Because He showed you. And if you study to show yourself approved, you're going to know. God give it to you. He said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness. And everything else should be added unto you. This is what God tells you. Seek first His kingdom and His righteousness. How did you get to know God? What did Jesus say? He said, repent for the kingdom of God is at hand. And then what Jesus say? He said, repent, for I am here. For I am here. This is what we must understand. God doesn't hide anything. God put everything out in the open for us to understand, for us to know, for us to be able to reach out, for us to understand who's first. The Word of God is saying to you, put your mind on the things above and not the things below. These things from below are earthly and worldly vessels. In Matthew 24:35, it said this, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall not pass away. Heaven and earth, y'all done heard that before, I know. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall live forever. Forever. So what's important? What is important for your life? What is important to your life? What is important in your life? This morning, Pastor Gary said what about the body? Absent from the body is what? Well, how can you be present with the Lord if you're not living with the Lord today? Huh? Say what? How? Just tell me how. I need to understand. How are you going to be present with the Lord if you don't listen to the Lord? If you don't listen to the word of God? If you don't acknowledge it and if you don't live it? The Bible tells us to let the mind that's in you be also the mind that was in Christ Jesus. Ain't that what the Bible tells us? Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word will live forever. The word of God said in Matthew's chapter 7, 26 and 30. It says this: do not worry about your life. Do not worry about what you will eat or what you will drink. Do not worry about your body, what you will put on or wear. Is not life more than food and body more than that of clothing? What is God telling us? Don't concern yourself with the things of this world. Yeah. Everything he told you not to worry about is things of this world. This world is not where you're going to be unless you're not serving God. And then you'll be with the worldly people. But if you're serving God, where would you be? Absent from the body is present with the Lord. That's what the Word of God teaches you. The Word of God is telling you how to live. God said in his word, he said, I put before you life and death. He said, I prefer that you choose life. How do you choose life? How do you choose life? By choosing Jesus Christ. That's how you choose life. You see, when you look at the birds in the air, God said this. He said, hey, neither sow nor reap, nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not more valuable than they? God is saying, stand in your faith. Believe the word that I send to you. Trust in me and I will guide you. God is saying that to you. God says, stand. Stand. When times get hard, don't run away. When you're going through a sickness and health problem, don't run away. When your pocket is empty like mine. Because my wife got all the money. Don't run away. When you think there's no food around to feed you, don't run away. Seek God. Seek righteousness. Seek kingdom. Can't be hungry for food. They give out food every day right here in this church. Huh? That's God giving it to you. It ain't coming from the people that passing out. They are servants of God. But the food is coming from God. Them clothes right there that Sister Teresa getting ready to pass out. And they said, don't worry about what you're going to wear because she's getting ready to give y'all some clothes. That's God giving you the clothes. Sister Teresa is the servant. God told her to give, and she is being obedient to the word. God say, don't run away. Don't worry about food, arrangement. Don't worry about these things. Because God will provide. Again, we must have faith in his promise that he will never leave us nor forsake us. You have already, you have a heavenly Father that knows your needs. Therefore, do not let the worries of this world become the center of attention in your life. Putting God first is removing all doubt and trust him knowing that. He's our Father. He's our source. He's our healer. He's our provider. He's our God. He's the only God. There's only one God. There's only one real God. Can't nobody look out the door and see the sunlight in the sky and the moon at night and the sky that hangs over us and tell me when it was created. Astronauts come constantly going up. They still can't tell you. They still can't reach the sky. I don't care how far they went, they cannot reach it. If God wanted them there, he'll let them come up there. Huh? Jesus said, where I go, I make a place for you. He said, if I can go, you can go too. Huh? What he said? He said, pick up your cross and carry it. I laid the footsteps out for you to follow. Nobody else. I laid them out. I left the footsteps in the sand. And I was carrying somebody at the same time. And that footstep that I left down there, I left them for you. Because if you truly want to come to where I'm going, you're going to follow them steps. You're going to pick up your cross. Not my cross, your cross. See, we can't handle Christ's cross. But you're going to pick up your cross and you're going to follow him. God gave a commandment to Adam and told him that disobedience will bring you death, will bring death to you and the human race. It will bring death to you. And you're the father of the human race. And whatever flowed through you, it's going to flow through them. See what? And then when God told him, and he was disobedient. And today we all going to die. All of us one day. If he hadn't been obedient, we'd been walking around listening to music, jumping, shouting, playing with all the animals. There will be no death. You got to listen to God and the things he say to you. You got to be obedient to God and the things he say to you. God told Abraham and Sarah, Abram and Sarai, at that time they hadn't even become Abraham and Sarah, that he was going to give them a child. And Sarah, which is Sarai, she lied. Until the day Isaac died, he was walking around with the name Isaac, meaning laughter. Laughter. God commanded Moses and told him and his brother Aaron. He told him to speak to the rock. That's what God told him. He told him to speak to the rock. Water just gonna flow. But they didn't speak to it. They hit the rock. Moses hit the rock. That ain't what God told him to do. Even though he hit the rock, the water just gushed out everywhere. He didn't do it the way God told him to do it. And without following God's word, without following God's commandments, without following what God had put in place for us, we're being disobedient. Putting God first is the title of the message today. How do you put God first? By loving the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. Matthew 22:37. That's putting God first. Putting God first is keeping our lives free from idolatry. Thou shalt not have no other God before me. Putting God first. 1 John 5:21. We must tear from our hearts anything that's lessened our devotion to the reverence of God. Dedicate ourselves as a living sacrifice to God, and in that way we put him first. Romans 12:1 means that we strive to follow in Jesus' steps. Strive, walk, give all you got to follow in the steps of Jesus Christ. That is putting God first. Jesus' life was characterized by total submission to the Father. Everything that Jesus did was because it was willed to him. It was what God had told him to do. Jesus was a perfect example of who we should be. Jesus was a perfect example of how we should live. Jesus was a perfect example of what it takes to get home to the Father. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. There's no other way to the Father but through me. Huh? Jesus walked the walk on this earth. He didn't just talk the talk. He talked the talk and walked the walk. He was a perfect example of life today that will bring you life after. Putting God first. Jesus' words, action, and doctrine all came from the Father. Jesus glorified the Father in every detail of his life and accomplish all that he has been sent to do.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Miracles, food, and healing. Putting God first becomes easy when we take to heart the word of God. There's only one way that you can put God first. And that's by studying his word. That's by allowing his word to come alive in you. That's by living his word day by day. Every step you take. And if you got to pray every time you take a step until you get it right, then you do it. Put God first in everything that you do. God will speak to you. God will talk to you. The Holy Spirit will come upon you. The Holy Spirit will come in you if you put God first.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
God told us in Romans 11:36, he said, everything comes from the Lord. All things were made because of him and will return to him. Praise the Lord forever. You can't win on your own. You know, because if you could, you wouldn't be sitting in here. What did I say? I can't win on my own. Because if I could, I wouldn't be standing right here. I can go out and make a million dollars, but if I don't have Jesus, I don't have nothing. I've seen so many times in life, people that get rich, and then they go broke and bankrupt, and then they kill themselves. Because they love money more than they did God. God said, you can't worship him and mammoth. You can't worship him and money. You got to love God first and foremost before anything. And when you love him, he's going to take care of you. You may not see it coming right then, but he's an on-time God. He never late. He's an on-time God. I've learned something over the years. Times I needed things, I said, oh God, this is going to happen and that's going to happen. God sitting up there just as patient as he can be. I got you. Then that day come that he give me what I asked for. And I look around and say, man, I really need this right now more than I did then. Because God knows your needs. God knows your wants. God knows your desires. God knows your heart. Only God can read your heart. And no one else can read your heart but God. Satan came and read your heart. Satan activate on your actions, not your heart. Things he know you did, things he know you like. You know, you go outside for an alcoholic and there's a gallon of liquor sitting on the sidewalk. For a drug smoker and there's a big old rock this big, man. Woo, I ain't never seen one that big. Well, cut it out, cut it out. Let's hit that, break that pipe, boy. It's enough for both of us. Oh, Satan get at you. He get at you at every turn. You know, every time you begin to move in your life. You ever know the little time something's getting good, it's always a little complication come in. A little problem, right? And Satan just wants you to just say, man, forget this. What God gonna do about this? I gotta handle this. That's what Satan wants you to do. But Job looked at his wife and said, woman, are you crazy? Me? I'm a curse to God that created me and gave me life. I came into this world naked, and I will leave this world naked. Because my spirit belongs to God. My sisters and brothers, if you want to know how to get the best results from God, put God first. Because when you put God first in your life, you serve every commandment. When you put God first in your life, you fulfill every commandment. That only means that before you do anything out of character, you're going to go to God and you're going to follow his advice. And he will show you who he is. God is good. And Jesus said he's the only one that's good. And we need to understand that. Ladies and gentlemen, sisters, brothers, friends, trust in the Lord with all thy heart.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. The title of today's message was Putting God First. Amen.
That was the word. Amen. Come on, let's give God some praise for your mother. messenger. Amen. The messenger. Amen. I don't have to say much. All I have to say is that this is the time for you to respond to the word. All love requires is a response. Amen. When the love of God goes forward, all God wants us to do is to respond to his love. Amen. So this is your part right now. This is the part where I know God has touched somebody's heart. I know God has touched somebody's heart, not only to give their life to the Lord, but somebody's been encouraged to get their walk back with God on today. Amen? So this is the part where we give you an opportunity to tell God, yes, put him first. Put him first. Amen? And I loved how he said, when you put God first, you fulfill the word of God. I've never heard it like that. But that's the word. Only God could have put it like that. Amen. So we have been blessed and we have been touched by God on today. And so now it's time for us to respond to his word. Amen. God said that when he knocks on your heart, don't harden it. Amen. Nobody's here by accident. Amen. So the altar is open right now. If you would like to give your life to God, if you would like to say yes to Jesus and put Jesus into your heart, amen. If you've never said yes to Jesus, isn't this a beautiful day to do that? Isn't it a beautiful day to do that? If you would like to give your heart to Christ, please come forward. This is the altar call. And I know that there is one. Come on, let's give him a hand and pray. The word of God does not return void. Amen. I know there's come on. I can shout right now.
Come on.
Amen. The word of God does not return void. I know there's somebody else that just may be a little shy. If you're too shy to come forward, if you just want to stand, amen. I see a young man standing. Amen. Amen. We're all here for you. We are all here for you. We're rooting for you. The other call is this. If there's someone under the sound of my voice, you may have already said yes to Christ, but you may have walked away from God. Who's the one that want to come back today? Come forward if you want to come back. Come on, let's give it a Lord. Come on, let's give it a Lord. You have to shout right now. This is shouting time right now. Hold on, though. Hold on. If you're too shy to come forward, you can stand. You don't have to come forward if you're a little shy. We're getting ready to say a prayer. We call it the sinner's prayer. This is the prayer that if you say it with a sincere heart, according to Romans 10:9, you shall be saved. But you got to decree and declare it out of your own mouth. Amen. This ain't the time to think it in your mind. Open up your mouth and let God know that this is your declaration. Let's pray. Dear God, forgive me of all my sins.
Forgive me of all my sins.
Cleanse me from all unrighteousness.
From all unrighteousness.
I believe Jesus died for my sins. I want him to be my Lord.
I want to be my Lord
and my Savior.
And my Savior.
Holy Spirit.
Fill me
with your power.
With your power.
Lead me.
Guide me.
Order my steps.
Satan, I rebuke you.
From this day forward,
I serve you no more.
I put you under my feet. In Jesus' name.
Dear God.